What's up guys, Rui here and welcome back to part 2 of my review on the Orbit Gear M100 BK version 3. Now, in part 1, I kind of just ran through the specs and features of the bag as well as gave my overall first impressions on it. Now I decided to split this into two parts just because I really want to test this bag out as I'm trying to be more of a minimalist, especially when it comes to my wardrobe. Therefore, I really needed something that will last me a long time and provide me with the versatility. Now, I know there are many amazing high quality bags out there, but a lot of them just don't fit my aesthetic or personal style. If you haven't watched part 1 of the review, I highly recommend you guys to go check it out before watching today's video. I'll leave the link somewhere up here. Moving on to part 2, I'll talk about the overall durability, capacity, storage, and comfort more in depth, as well as things that I noticed throughout my usage of it. I'll also show you guys how I transform and double up this bag as my everyday carry as well as my camera bag. Trust me when I say I really did put this bag to test when I was over in Iceland. From walking around the town of Reykjavik to glacier hikes, this bag was with me the entire time. Firstly, I would say that this bag is seriously well made. Even after overstuffing it with so much stuff, chucking it over the compartments and bringing it around everywhere I go, the stitching and threading of this bag is still able to hold up really well. As of today, there are still no frill threadings or signs of wear and tear. Same goes with all the zippers, hooks, loops, and buckles. Even the grit system is able to hold up really well after attaching a pretty heavy loaded mod. I definitely abused this bag as to how much you're supposed to carry, and although it's still able to hold up really well, I still feel that this bag is still meant for the light to medium users. If you do carry a lot of things, then I still highly suggest getting a backpack. It allows you to carry more things as well as in a more comfortable manner. Orbit Gear do produce a couple of backpacks that you can check out. I've not had the proper opportunity to really test out this bag in terms of its waterproofness, but I would say that the waterproof Alucor 580 Daniel Fabric does its job pretty well. It surely is no Gore-Tex material or anything like that, because unlike Gore-Tex where water would just slip right through the fabric leaving it feeling dry, the Alucor fabric will kind of absorb water, but it doesn't allow the water to penetrate inside the bag. It's just wet externally. However, a small concern I have with this bag when it comes to the waterproofness is the main zipper. Now, once it's fully zipped up, there is still a tiny hole whereby water may potentially seep in. Unfortunately, my bag came with a small defect. A small part of the nylon webbing was not stitched, hence there is a gap. Now, to be honest, at first, when I first received it, I thought that it was made like this to accommodate bigger mods. But after further researching, I saw that it's just a part that they did not stitch on mine. I will be contacting Orbit Gear to sort this issue out and hopefully get it fixed. Now, I'm not too worried as their customer service is super fast and responsive. When it comes to storage capacity, this bag is no slouch. Although it's only 16 liters, because it doesn't have any smaller compartments inside of it, you are able to fully utilize its storage capacity. In addition to that, it can also expand to be pretty wide. Now, this is something that I really like about this bag because there are many messenger bags out there that are able to do so. I also really like the bag's secret compartment as it has a zipper that can be locked, which is a really nice touch. One thing to note is that as an everyday carry bag, it can get a little too big. There are days where I just don't need to carry so many things and just wish that I had a smaller bag. But you know what, your boy's trying to be minimal, so yeah, I gotta live with it. As to how I transformed this bag into my camera bag is by getting one of these, a camera cube. Now because this bag is not meant to store camera equipment, it does not have any paddings or compartmental sections. Therefore, if you were to put your camera in it, it might get damaged from all the moving around and potentially knocking onto stuff. Now the one that I have is the small camera cube by Peak Design. It has padding all over it as well as compartmental sections to help me protect and organize all my camera equipment. In addition to that, it is also fully waterproof. With my bag being kind of waterproof as well, it kind of double reassures me that all my camera equipment will be safe and dry. It is on the slightly pricier side, but you really are paying for quality here. If this isn't your type, then there are many other camera cubes out there. You just need to do your research and find ones that suits you. A tip if you're planning to convert this bag into a camera bag or anything else, just make sure you measure the dimensions of the bag as well as whatever you're planning to fit inside of it. Lastly, comfort-wise, I'll rate this bag relatively average. The sling does not have any padding, thus if you do carry a lot of things, it will kind of dig into your shoulders a little bit. However, at least for me, I felt that the Axis sling strap really do help to take some weight off my shoulders, and it secures the bag really nicely, therefore there is no swinging left to right when you're walking or running. Overall, I'm seriously impressed, and if you have an interest in tech or functional wear, you should definitely check out Orbit Gear. That's it for my review on this bag. Hopefully my insights was helpful to you guys, and if it did help out, then don't forget to like this video. Thank you all so much for checking out today's video. If you're new here, then definitely don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Till then guys, I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.